The 12th man, a force of nonstop energy and passion. But where does the term come from and how has it evolved? This is Traditions, presented by Graduate Hotels, a series about college football's incredible idiosyncrasy. The Seahawks, Colts, and Bills have all tried making the 12th man native to their own fan bases. But well before any of those teams were in the National Football League, Texas A&M University had a 12th player standing ready to assist. As the legend goes, on January 2, 1922, the underdog Aggies squared off against top-ranked Center College in the Dixie Classic. Up in the press box that day was a squad player named E. King Gill, who began that day helping reporters identify players on the field below. Due to a rash of injuries, A&M's bench dwindled, and its coach searched for additional bodies. So late in the first quarter, he waved Gill down to the sideline and told him to suit up. Gill never actually got in the game, but he stood ready in case he was needed. And of course, when the clock hit all zeros, the Aggies had pulled off one of the greatest upsets in college football history, solidifying the legend. Texas Monthly recently found a researcher who has poked holes in the E. King Gill story. But nevertheless, for much of the 20th century, the tale grew and grew. Songs have been written.
We're the 12th man on that fighting Aggie team.
Plenty of merchandise has been produced, and banners have been hung, making the Aggies home to the 12th man. By the mid-1980s, competition for the term emerged. In December 1984, the Seattle Seahawks retired the jersey number 12, in honor of their famously loud crowd, though lawsuits soon followed. In 1992, Buffalo honored their 12th man in the Bills Wall of Fame, but a 2007 licensing deal made it so that Buffalo could only use the term on the side of its home stadium. That same year, the Colts inducted their 12th man as the sixth member of the team's Ring of Honor. But less than a decade later, Indy agreed to stop using it after becoming the third NFL team to face the wrath of A&M's lawyers over its use. In recent years, the Seahawks have found a workaround. They've steered clear from A&M's 12th man and have instead filed trademarks for just 12, the 12s, and we are 12s. The subtle difference is significant, but in each case, the meaning is the same, a desire to recognize the passion of a team's fan base. So when you watch an A&M game this season, or a Seahawks game for that matter, remember E. King Gill, the original 12th man.